I've made myself, oh, on the wonk there, that's not very good. I've made myself some sort of, what is, the camera's just moving by itself. There we go, that's better. I've made myself some sort of omelette-y thing with tomatoes and avocado on toast on the side. You'll never guess what. It's finally stopped raining. I can't quite believe it. It feels like it has rained non-stop here for about 2 weeks. And as a British person, I feel like it's my rite of passage to be allowed to moan about the weather, or at least comment on the weather, because it has affected my mood so much the past week or so. So to wake up this morning to blue skies was an instant mood lifter. But sadly, I'm quite busy today. I'm trying to film the cutaways for the wardrobe review video. So that will be up this evening. The reason I'm starting this vlog today is because Monday and Tuesday were a complete washout in terms of both weather and productivity. Monday, we went out to shoot a campaign that I've got coming up, or like a continued partnership I've got coming up with this airbag helmet company. And it just rained, it didn't really go to plan. And then yesterday was, what happened yesterday? Another day of rain and trying to get things done, trying to shoot, but the weather didn't permit. So today, as soon as I saw it was blue skies, I was like, right, camera at the ready, I'm going to get filming these cutaways immediately so I can get this video up today. I'm beginning to wonder if it will ever stop raining here in the UK or if this is just it forevermore. As you can tell, I've not woken up in a great mood, but that's just because my mood can be often quite easily affected by the weather, and it's just feels like it's not going to end. Anyway, I'm very pleased because this weather is a great excuse to wear my new chocolate brown Kessel coat that was sent to me by Farfetch as part of a sponsorship for this vlog. So once I get home, I will sit down and talk to you a little bit more about Farfetch and the bits that they sent me ready for autumn winter, because they sent me an absolutely gorgeous handbag that I think a lot of you will appreciate. Right, I've attempted to fix my post-rain hair. So this section of the vlog is sponsored, oh my god, a spider literally just fell from the curtains. Oh my god, it's huge. Okay, that's not like a spider I've ever seen before. Okay, I'm just gonna let that do what it's gonna do. Oh, I thought it was gonna, I literally thought it was gonna go on the camera. Anyway, this section of the vlog is sponsored by Farfetch. So Farfetch very kindly got in touch and asked if I would like to pick out a few pieces for the autumn winter season. Now, Farfetch is a shop, well, it's not a shop, it's a website that I use quite regularly in order to basically hunt down things that are quite hard to find, because Farfetch isn't a shop itself. Farfetch it's almost like a hub in which you can shop lots of different independent shops. So when you're browsing through Farfetch, you are kind of browsing through a huge catalogue of shops that are worldwide. So it's a really great way to support independent sellers, because most of the time when you're ordering through Farfetch, you're ordering from a lovely small boutique somewhere in Europe or... Hello? I'm just doing... Okay. Right, okay.
You're
right. Yeah, I'm just trying to film something and I've already been interrupted by a spider and now I've been interrupted by you. Right, where was I before I got rudely interrupted? Oh yes, so you can shop at Farfetch quite confidently knowing that you're supporting a lovely independent boutique somewhere around the world. I also really like using Farfetch because they tend to always have those really hard to find items in stock. There's been several times that I've used Farfetch, my Calvin Klein boots. Found those on Farfetch when they were like gold dust and couldn't find them anywhere else. And they're very, very good for, they're great for Kessel. They're a great Kessel stockist. They tend to have a really good range of Kessel on there. And I also find if you're shopping La Mer, which as a clue as to what's coming next, they also have a very good range of La Mer products. So yeah, Farfetch 10 out of 10. A very, very good website when shopping high-end pieces, hard-to-find brands, that kind of thing. So just to let you all know, before I show you what I picked out, I have a code that you can use on Farfetch that will get you 10% off. I'll put it on the screen here. There are some T's and C's, which I will put in the description box as well. So the first item I'm going to show you is a Newcastle coat, which if you watch my wardrobe review video, you will have seen a sneak peek of it there. So it's the same as the orange one that I own, but it is in this exquisite dark chocolate burgundy colour. It's probably going to look a bit more purple on the viewfinder, but in real life, it's a very dark chocolate with a slight purple hint to it. Now this kind of colour, sort of like a burgundy colour, is normally something that I would run the opposite direction from. I'm not a fan of burgundy. I have not worn burgundy for a very long time. I think the last burgundy thing I owned was maybe 6 years ago. I used to have a Celine Trio, which I never wore because I just always thought that burgundy wasn't my colour. It wasn't a colour that suited me. I felt like I couldn't make it work for me. I don't know, there was just something about burgundy that just I didn't like. But this shade of burgundy has really drawn me in. My opinion might be changed towards burgundy. Maybe it's more those sort of like more reddy toned burgundies I struggle with. This is very, very dark. It's very subtle. So the jacket is exactly the same as the orange rubber one that I currently own. This, however, has some nice white contrasting details inside. So whereas my orange one is completely orange, this one has all white inside. I especially love the double placket. This is a white, almost waxed cotton. Fully tested this out this morning when I went out in the rain, as you saw. Completely waterproof. And just wiped it all down when I got in just to double check that there was no marks on there. And yeah, I was dry. It was great. So I'm actually going to put this on after I've shown you the next item just to show you how it looks full length styled, because it's been, I mean, I always find castle coats really fun to style because of the nature of the coats, but as a colour I've also found it quite fun to style because it feels like it's put a new lease of life in my wardrobe. I am a creature of habit. I veer towards navy, grey, beige. So when something like this comes along, it does refresh your wardrobe quite a lot. Like a very subtle colour can really refresh your wardrobe without feeling like you're straying too far out of your comfort zone. For me, I mean, I like colour, but I like it in a muted sense, I guess. So this is a very good way for me to explore colour in that way. So yeah, I'll pop that on in just a moment after I've shown you the next thing. It came in this rather exquisite dust bag. I'm just going to get it out. I'm not going to try and create suspense or anything like that. It is the La Mer camera bag, called the camera bag for obvious reasons. This is one of those bags that I feel is, when I think of the La Mer brand, I think of this as such an iconic bag of theirs, along with the, is it called the egg? I think it's the egg bag, the one that's like that kind of round shape with the big chunky handle. And it's one of those bags that it's always been in sort of like my mental internal wish list for years and years and years. And anytime I went to Paris, I'd always pop into the La Mer store, because that La Mer store is beautiful and iconic in itself, to swoon over this bag. And it is, oh, it's exquisite. Flap at the front, it's very, very simple. Flap at the front that's magnetic. Inside you have one large pocket, and then there is a slimmer pocket here with an adjustable strap. I have this on the shortest one. I'll just show you where it comes down on my body. Sorry, I've just got my comfy trousers on. I just put them on as soon as I got back in. But yeah, this is how it is on me. I think that's the shortest one I've got it on. But you'll see as a recurring pattern with handbags that I like, they don't have much hardware and they always have a sort of sculptural element. For me, this bag really feels like a work of art. It's one of those pieces where I'm just like, I can't quite believe I own this now after all these years. So thank you so, so much to Farfetch. I was a bit like, when they emailed me. This is how I would style it in a very casual way. And this is actually how I had it styled this morning when you saw me outside, with a hoodie underneath. I've popped it on with my navy ami trousers because I think burgundy and navy is a lovely combination. Didn't wear these out this morning because, quite frankly, did not want to get them soaked. But I quite like them, this paired with some sort of sporty trainers. I kind of like this sort of off-duty model look, although, you know, I'm not an off-duty model by any means. But yeah, this morning I had this hoodie on and was like, right, I just need to get out of the house and just put my castle coat over it. And actually, I like it. I'm not really a hoodie person, but cozy. I'm enjoying this quite a lot. The bag. Need to put the bag on, don't I? So this is how they look together. By the way, the coats are size extra small, and I'm 5'3" for reference. Just for anyone who's on the shorter side and is just wondering how castle coats look on more petite frames, voila. And the La Mer bag, can we all agree, does look absolutely stunning alongside the chocolate brown. So yeah, thank you very much to Farfetch for sponsoring this portion of the vlog. Farfetch is one of those websites that I can spend hours and hours and hours browsing through just all of the absolutely gorgeous brands they have on there. You can fully expect this bag and this coat to be making regular appearances from now on. I can already tell this is pretty much going to be my uniform, so to speak, for the rest of autumn and winter. So yeah, I'm really into this. This is one of those outfits where I was just sort of like, oh, I don't really think this is going to work, but I just need to get out of the house real quick. And I'm actually really into it. I can't quite believe it. After what feels like 2 solid days of editing, the wardrobe review coats video is finally complete. It's now uploading to YouTube as I talk to you. It is 1 hour and 3 minutes long. I do not expect anyone to sit through an hour plus of me talking about coats. If you do make it through the end, you deserve a medal, because honestly, I can't believe, I mean, I've tried to trim it down, honestly. Massive learning curve though, that video, and for this series, I think they need to be defined into smaller chunks, because to do a video all on coats, in hindsight, was probably a bad idea. It probably should have been trenches, wool coats, jackets, as opposed to just coats. Anyway, lesson learned, and it's definitely some food for thought going forward with this wardrobe series. I had to put my glasses on because my eyes hurting so much this week because I've just been on my computer loads. But please go and watch a little bit of it, even if you don't watch the whole thing, just a little bit of it, because I feel like I've put my soul into this video this week. And I am pleased with the outcome, regardless of the stupidly long length. So yeah, it's now 20 to 5 and I feel knackered, and all I've done is sit at a computer all day. Dean just brought fish and chips home for tea, and I cannot wait for this. He's had a really long day, I've had a long day. The weather outside is so horrible. It just feels like one of those evenings where you just sit on the sofa, eat fish and chips, and just do nothing for the rest of the evening. I cannot wait for this. I can't remember the... I haven't had fish and chips in months, I don't think. So good. I can't have fish and chips without mushy peas. How does everyone else have their fish and chips? I tend to have my chips swimming in vinegar. Like, literally swimming. And then a little bit of salt, not too much. I'm recording, by the way.
What?
I recorded that, by the way. I don't know if that's a bit too many chips.
Classic. No, that looks good.
The portion size is always massive.
Mm. No, it's only a small chips.
But I haven't put vinegar or salt on yours just yet. Okay. Oh, that was exactly what I needed this morning. I feel so much better after a swim. Is anyone else's mind just at capacity at the moment? I am really struggling to concentrate on any task that I'm attempting to do at the moment because there's just so much going on in my mind surrounding COVID and just this year. So it feels like my brain is travelling at a million miles per hour, but my body doesn't want to travel as fast as my brain. And I'm just struggling. This week I've felt so wobbly in terms of anxiety and worry. I woke up at 5 o'clock this morning and couldn't get back to sleep, just with anxiety, for no real reason. And my mind isn't muddled for any specific reason. There's just so much going on and I can't concentrate and I feel out of control. That's it, my mind feels out of control. Is anyone else having that? I think it's because everything is feeling really, really uncertain again at the moment, surrounding potential lockdown here in the UK, and yeah, just it's all a bit and I'm struggling to kind of keep myself level-headed.
It looks like a might be like sort of garlic bread.
Oh, that is a nice chair. That's so nice.
It's nice, isn't it? I'm gonna get it.
Just found myself a new office chair. Not bad, is it?
Lovely. Today.
Win-win. Come back and get that later. These are absolutely terrifying.
Just a nice nightmare.
Hello.
Why would you want them? They're so scary. I've just started using this new Burberry Essentials Glow Palette as my bronzer, blusher and highlighter. And I must say, although my makeup always looks quite rubbish on camera, I'm really pleased with how it's looking in real life at the moment. And I've had a few compliments on my makeup since switching to this palette, which is always quite nice when you change your makeup and you get a compliment, because it's like, oh, okay, people have noticed, you know, this has made a difference. So the palette is made up of six shades. You've got these two are, what does it say, Sculpt, which are obviously bronzers. Then you've got two blushes and then you've got two highlights. I've been using the bottom three and I'm not usually one for powder blushes or powder highlights, but I do have kind of combination skin. I get oily in the T-zone, and well, I like to call it the H-zone. I get oily across here, down and across, and I've always been like, oh yeah, a cream product is much more natural looking, but for my skin texture I started to wonder if actually maybe a powder product is slightly better. So I thought, right, I'm going to try all three of these and I'm loving the results. So I've just kind of popped a little bit of the bronzer on to all the usual places I put it. Actually, I'm going to put some on my eyelids. And then, am I going to switch brush? No, I'll stick with this. This is the Hourglass. I don't know what this brush is called, but it's brilliant. It's my favourite brush. I've got two because I love them so much. So I'm going to use the smaller end for my blusher. And I'm just going to take it quite high up on my cheekbones. It was slightly on the apple, but not too much, because I find for my face shape, it's just a little bit more flattering if I go higher up rather than like straight onto the apple. I've got no idea how this is going to look on camera. But I've just found that this trio of powders has made me look very glowy. And I think when at this time of year, you instantly just feel like your skin looks dull. Feels like your skin needs, well, it does need a lot more hydration. And I always just think I look quite lackluster. I'm just taking this MAC, oh, this is so old, 129 brush, and just popped a little bit of highlight on the brush. Let's just take that onto the cheekbone, you know, the usual places where I'd take the highlight. And then take my little finger and put a little bit into the corner of my eyes. I must say, I do like Burberry makeup. I do like the textures of their powders. I haven't used their foundation for a long, long time because I don't wear foundation anymore, but I used to be a big fan of their foundations and primers. Just blend that in. I've got no idea if any of that is showing up on camera, but I can assure you, in real life, it looks very nice. I'm pleased with how my makeup is looking at the moment. Just to add to the glowiness, Hourglass Ambient Lighting Infinity Powder. If you've not tried an Hourglass powder, I urge you to do so. They are incredible. They are so finely milled that the texture on your face is practically flawless and undetectable. Because they are so fine though, they are quite delicate, so they're not the kind of product that I tend to put in my handbag because I get worried that they're going to break quite easily. But incredible product nonetheless. I'll try and show you how it looks in the palette. You can see it's quite marbled. It's probably about three or four different colours in there. Just using a Bioterry brush. Anything big and fluffy I find is really good for these powders, and barely taking any product onto the brush and just swiping all over, because I don't want to completely mattify my skin, because I don't like that really matte look. I just want to take the oiliness down a little notch, because I'm all for glow. And sometimes oily skin, you know, works in your favour, but other times it doesn't work in your favour and you just look a little bit sweaty. So this just calms that down a little bit. And then to just add a little something to my lips, I've been using the Make Bizu Bizu Lip and Cheek Stick. I think I've mentioned this before. I've been using this on my lips for a long time, although I think I might need to throw this away soon, which is quite sad, because with natural beauty products, they don't last very long. So just take the smallest bit on my finger and then literally just like, in quite a messy manner, smush it all on my lips. Try not to go on the outline, you know, outside of my lips, but just sort of, you know, that effortless smudge. So yeah, that is how my makeup is looking at the moment. Here he is, in his new chair. You look very comfortable.
It is welcome.
So we just did some research, didn't we, and found out that the chair...
It is a PF Alpha...
Oh, it says it on the label. Oh, we just sat in the car on the way back because we've just been to see Dean's family. We sat in the car trying to find out where this chair originated, because we just picked it up from an antique store that's close to ours, and it said it on the label the whole time.
So, shall I tell you what it is?
So it was designed by a designer called Tim Bates. Is that right?
That's right, yeah.
For a furniture brand called...
Yeah.
PF Alpha, I think it was something like that.
I think Alpha is the chair.
Maybe the chair name.
So it's PF, like P-I-E-F-F.
Yeah. I'll link below, because whilst researching, found quite a few...
Why don't everyone getting this?
Oh, well...
This one's kind of...
I mean, it's in quite nice condition.
It's in quite good condition.
Like a little,
just needs a little polish up, doesn't it?
Yeah, there's a little TLC.
Just need a footstool for it now, don't you? And then you've got your lounging chair, because the dream was always to get a Charles and Ray Eames chair, but unfortunately we don't have a spare £9,000 or however much they are.
Like the day that we then just stumbled across this.
Why has it stopped recording? Oh no, it's still recording, sorry.
New camera. So yeah. We never find good things here.
No, we never find good secondhand furniture.
No.
But someone messaged me on Instagram and recommended an antique shop in Holt. Which could be one to try out. It's wet and it's cold outside, so this evening's dinner is going to be kind of a shepherd's pie. We've switched out the lamb for beef, haven't we, make it. We're basically making cottage pie, but we couldn't find a cottage pie recipe in any of our books. So we just found this shepherd's pie one in a Jamie Oliver book. I cannot wait for this. I can't remember the last time I had cottage pie.
It's been a while.
It has been a while.
Especially.
Is there going to be enough mash?
To sort of spread it out.
It'll just be a thin topping of mash.
No, that'll be right once it's spread around.
Oh yeah, there'll be enough. I'm just here to finesse. I can't remember what this technique is called with the fork. It does have a name.
Forking.
Voila. Should we get it in the oven?
Yeah, maybe make it a bit more sort of like peaks and...
Oh, it's not fluffy enough for that.
Oh, sorry, is my mash not good enough?
I don't really know how to do it in peaks. You sort of like whip it up.
Alright, I'll give it a little go.
Does that look a bit better?
Yeah, that looks good.
You're lying.
No, it looks fine.
I'll let you try it.
It's going to steam up the camera.
Oh yeah, that looks so good.
It does look good, doesn't it?
Oh yeah, it's gone nice and crispy. Mm-mm-mm. Just sat in front of my computer adding the last clips from today to the vlog. It's now almost 7:30, so I would like to get this wrapped up and uploaded before the end of the day so you can sit and watch it all this evening. I hope everyone's doing well. This week has been an alright week, but the weekend I've really tried my best not to think too much about what might happen tomorrow. So tomorrow here in England, Boris is doing another announcement, I think tomorrow afternoon, which will be COVID related, and there's lots of rumours flying around about what the new rules and restrictions will be. The biggest rumour is that there will be a lockdown tier system, so there will be 3 different tiers of lockdown, and those different tiers will be applied to different areas of England. I think places in the north are already under different lockdown restrictions as to, say, what we are here further down south. So yeah, I'm trying not to think about that too much. I've just tried to really immerse myself in just having a nice weekend, lots of good food, went and saw family, did furniture shopping, like just try my best not to think too much about what might happen tomorrow. I think, it's hard not to worry though, isn't it? Especially because we've seen, I think Scotland have now got a restriction which means they can't mix households, they can't even go into each other's gardens, I don't think. And their pubs and restaurants are closing at 6 p.m. and they're not allowed alcohol indoors, they can have alcohol outdoors. I'm guessing the logic I can see behind that is to deter people from going indoors and get more people sat outside. That's the only logic I can see behind that restriction. And then there has also been, I think there was a rumour, or maybe there were some pubs and restaurants that were just told to completely shut in areas of the north. So yeah, everyone's experience is very different all over England at the moment, and all over the UK, to be honest. I know Wales has got they're talking about different travel restrictions to us here in England. I know Ireland has got completely different restrictions to us, so it's all very up and down at the moment here in the UK. Any anxiety sufferers out there who like to pick their fingers, my fingers, actually this hand's not too bad, but whenever I get an anxiety flare up, my main kind of coping mechanism I do is pick my fingers. It's not really, I don't really bite my nails, it's more like picking the skin around my nails, and I will do it to quite a brutal extent. Like my fingers will be bleeding and I'll need a plaster, but it's something I've really tried not to do this weekend, but today my thumb has taken quite a battering. So yes, we will just see what tomorrow brings, but I do hope that everyone is well. This time of year, even without COVID, this change in the season can be quite difficult for people, even though we know it's coming every year and we know what to expect every year. I do think it is still a struggle every year, especially as the nights draw in quicker and quicker. But yeah, I hope everyone is very well, and thank you so much for watching, and I shall see you all next week.